all my directors who are here and all the directors who are not here, because this is not possible where I am standing. And I won't be here. I will talk about that when I'm asked to in a bit, I'm sure. So I'm not taking my time. This is a good evening, and thank you. This is extremely humbling, and I'm very, very grateful that something like this is happening to someone like me. So thank you, everybody, for all the way, Royal Sag, all the illustrators, writers, and some of the hosts. So thank you for being here. This is extremely special. Thank you very much.
So that was just a glimpse of the journey. I would like to invite Piyu sir again and sir again on stage. As you can see, I'm the thinnest, so I'm taking the smallest chair from the stage. That's what they gave me. So, you know, I just want to, go back to playing journalist once again, because that's what gives me the most excitement. And you're on the couch again, and I'm here. So, I just want to start by asking you, you know, the characters that you have played over the last 25 years, you know, do you think that today you are a combination of all those characters? That is the real Shah Rukh for the audiences, a combination of everything that you have done on screen?
First of all, it's extremely awkward and difficult for me to sit in front of people who've made my life in different years of my life from the time I've started, whether it's Kundan or Rajiv or Abbas Bhai, Mastan Bhai, Praveen Saab, Ramesh Sipriji. There's so many of them, and I'll talk about each one of them individually. Or Shimit, if he's here. And I don't understand how to say this and explain it. I think an actor's journey is defined by the kind of people and the life he leads or she leads. And mine has been defined by my circumstances, my experiences maybe, and of course a lot of direction from these wonderful men and women. So I have never sat down and analyzed that the characters that I've played, do they come from just a part of me, or have I become a part of the act? Or have I become a part of, I said this to somebody once, I don't know, do I cry like Devdas or Devdas cries like me? I have no idea. Kundan will tell you, he's an awful actor. So, because these are like my father figures, these are like mentors and guides. And each criticism, each slap, each love, each anger of theirs, I hold very dear to my heart. So whenever I'm going wrong or right, or I don't know how to do it, I just fall back upon the people I work with and say, what would Rajiv say? What would Kundan say? Abbas Bhai, Mastan Bhai, aake mere ko sweetly criticize kaise karenge? And I will figure out how to do it. I do my best. I try to listen to the instruction, and I've never analyzed. I don't think any actor or actress should give themselves more importance than the fact they're supposed to just do a job and you know, emote when they're called upon to do so.
But you know, the one thing that came across from all filmmakers was the fact that you completely believed in their vision. And like Rajiv has said that, you know, you never asked him before making a fool of yourself on screen. You were not worried about whether your hair was in the right place or you were looking good. You know, Abbas Hassan Bhai have said that you never questioned the fact that you had to push this girl and you had to kill her. You never had those questions. So was it the belief that you had in the filmmakers?
Or you I think it, I'm sorry, I'm not going to show off, but I think it's both, there are two things. One is belief in the filmmaker, because I believe a film is a director's medium. So jinki aankhein ye film bana rahi hain, unki aankhon ke zariye audience usko dekhti hai. So Rajiv ki film ka ek tarika hoga, Praveen ki film ka ek tarika hoga, aur inka ek apna belief or system hoga writing ka, and all of them, Kundan ka hoga. And वही ऑडियंस जो है उस तरीके मेरी नज़रों से नहीं देखेगी. एंड द सेकंड पार्ट इज, सो यू हैव टू बिलीव इन द डायरेक्टर. एंड सेकंड पार्ट इज, यू हैव टू बिलीव इन योरसेल्फ एज एन एक्टर, दैट व्हाटएवर यू मेक मी डू, आई विल डू इट टू द बेस्ट ऑफ माय कैपेबिलिटी. I find it very wrong when actors turn around on a set and say, my character won't say these lines. But he's your character. You're making him or her. You are the maker at that point of time. How dare you say these lines won't work for my character? So I can say anything. I can have my hair the way I want to, even now. I can do anything. If somebody tells me in an emotional scene, do a somersault, I'll do it. I'll make it believable because I'm an actor. So I think you have to have belief in the person who's directing you, guiding you, and in yourself. And that's all it takes to be an actor.
It's your show, but I will contribute a little bit. Because I think you are being too modest. I think every interaction, we all believe in a captain, and the director is the captain. And if you're a player, you have an interaction with the captain. And it always happens, and I see my two favorite cricketers sitting out there. I've called them cricketers all my life, because they're the only one in whites all the time.
And test cricketers.
Yes, test cricketers, because they're into purity. I'm sure that you have interactions with them, you respect their view, but you contribute. And to my mind, it's always an interaction that evolves with your due respect of saying you are the captain. So there is a side of you which contributes always, and I want you to talk about it without modesty.
I'm actually not being modest. Honestly, I'm not known for that. मैं दो बातें कहूँगा जब मैं छोटा था तो माई मदर वॉज वेरी सोशल एंड मेट एवरी वन सो आई नोटिस दिस कि वो जिनके साथ बैठकर बात करती थी वैसी ही हो जाती थी सो अगर वो वर्कर था तो वर्कर की तरह अगर वो आर्मी ऑफिसर था तो आर्मी की तरह बिजनेसमैन था पॉलिटिशियन था एंड आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाट एन एक्टर शुड बी कि वो जहाँ बैठे जिसके साथ उठे बैठे जिससे बात करे एंड दैट एक्चुअली मीन्स द डायरेक्टर यू शुड बिकम लाइक दैट एन एक्टर शुड बी आई थिंक मनोज कुमार जी की फिल्म का गाना है विच आई टेक वेरी क्लोज टू माई हार्ट एज एन एक्टर पानी रे पानी तेरा रंग कैसा जिसमें मिला दो लगे उस जैसा सो आई थिंक एन एक्टर इज जस्ट वाटर एंड इन शेप एंड इन कलर एंड विच एवर कलर इफ आई गेट इन टू वाइट विद द बास्मसान देन आई एम वाइट वाटर
अगेन यू आर बीइंग मॉडेस्ट बिकॉज व्हाट यू आर टॉकिंग इज अबाउट अ कैटलिस्ट कि कैटलिस्ट डिसअपीयर हो जाता है कैटलिस्ट अपना काम कर जाता है
बिकॉज आई ट्रूली बिलीव द आर्ट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट द आर्टिस्ट इज नॉट सो
आई एग्री विद यू इन एवरीथिंग दैट यू से
आखिर में रह जाएगा तो आई थिंक राहुल राज यही सब रह जाएंगे मैं तो नहीं रह जाऊंगा
मोहन गोपाल
या सो इट्स द आर्ट रिमेन्स आई डोंट थिंक द आर्टिस्ट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट
आई डोंट कंप्लीटली इन दिस
एंड एज लॉन्ग एज आई कैन थिंक लाइक दैट आई थिंक आई कैन एक्ट विद सम अमाउंट ऑफ प्योरिटी व्हाट एवर लिटिल आई नो ऑफ एक्टिंग आई डोंट क्लेम टू नो टू मच बट व्हाट एवर लिटिल आई नो द प्योरिटी विल बी रिटेन्ड If I'm able to believe that my art is more important than myself.
But the one thing that you know comes to mind, and talking to a lot of filmmakers also sir, came to mind, was that do you feel that you know becoming a star restricts the number of characters that you can play? Because you know when you were beginning off, the zone of the characters that you were trying out at that time, you know, did you think that got limited? And case in point being maybe a fan where. People were hoping to see a star and not a character. Does that come in the way of choosing films today because you're such a huge star?
I think it's a good excuse to use, and a good reason also, if not just an excuse. कि यार वो stardom जो है बहुत सारी चीजें हैं जो actor की life से निकाल लेती हैं. Then you become a star, and the struggle is like that. And yeah, when you become a star, you have little issues. कि यार अभी तो बहुत ज़्यादा हो गया है मुझसे ज़्यादा लोगों को ट्विटर पे मालूम होता है कि इतना बिजनेस किया है फिल्मों ने सो यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट कि यार ये 100 करोड़ 200 करोड़ 300 करोड़ एंड हम कितने भी उससे अनटच्ड रहें अछूते रहें लेकिन कहीं ना कहीं पर ये बातें तो दिमाग में रहती हैं एंड एज अ स्टार 10 लोग मिलेंगे कि यार ये फिल्म दिवाली में रिलीज़ करो ईद में रिलीज़ करो क्रिसमस में फिर इतना पैसा बनेगा सो ऑल दोज थिंग्स रिमेन इन योर हेड यू आर इन द बिजनेस यू आर इन द इंडस्ट्री ऑफ फिल्म मेकिंग So that business remains in the head. But I still like to believe ki jabhi bhi mujhe mauka mila hai ya kabhi bhi mujhko chance mila hai ki you know you do a fan or you do a Chak De India maine kabhi usko question nahi kiya I'll say yeah of course I'll do it as long as you want to make it with me इट्स नॉट, मैंने कभी फिल्म डिजाइन नहीं की है कि मैं अब ऐसा रोल प्ले करूंगा. एंड द लिमिटेशंस आल्सो कम फ्रॉम पीपल हु आर मेकिंग फिल्म्स विद यू समटाइम्स. यू नो, अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल विल टेक मी इन अ फिल्म एंड से, अरे यार ये ऑफ बीट क्यों बनाए, कमर्शियली बना देते हैं. आई एम नॉट ब्लेमिंग देम, आई थिंक इट्स अ गुड थॉट. एंड अगर मैं बिकता हूँ तो बेचना लाजमी है. आई कांट बी टू फेस्ड अबाउट इट बिकॉज आई सेल सो मेनी थिंग्स एंड आई थिंक इट्स अ बिजनेस फाइनली. But having said that, I've tried to maintain some kind of balance. Earlier on, I had nothing to lose. So I did a lot of things I didn't even question. Now maybe, I don't question, but people around me question. You think it will do well? You think you should do a love story again? You should, I don't listen to anyone.
But does it restrict you in your choices?
No, not at all. Sometimes it's awkward to say that being in this position, the choices are less. People give me less choices. Main alag alag directors ke saath baithta hoon, wo, sir, hum picture banayenge. पहले ही बड़ी बन जाती है. सो इट्स अ लिटिल कि नहीं पिक्चर बना लेते हैं एंड देन इट गोज आउट ऑफ हैंड समटाइम्स बिकॉज एवरीबडी वांट्स द फिल्म टू बी बिग एंड एवरीबडी इज होली ग्रेल इज टू डू दैट ब्यूटिफुल आर्टिस्टिक फिल्म व्हिच डज कमर्शियली वेरी वेल. सो आई थिंक एवरीबडी अटेम्प्ट्स दैट बट इन दैट अटेम्प्ट समटाइम्स यू गेट इट हाफ राइट, समटाइम्स यू गेट इट कंप्लीटली रॉन्ग.
So would you also feel that now, you know, you're also coming into a phase of your career where, you know, a new lot of filmmakers you're working with. You started your career with, you know, filmmakers. Then you had the middle lot where you worked with Karan and Ashutosh and Adi and Shimit. And now there's a new lot of filmmakers. So are you, is this the adventure or let's say the spirit of taking risks again happening, or are you just working with these new filmmakers because they came to you with scripts that excited you?
Part is true, yeah. If somebody comes to me with a script, I've never thought he's an old filmmaker or new filmmaker. If I am in that zone of wanting to do a comedy, I do it with whoever has got the comedy at that point in time. But having said that, most of the people here, if I'm not mistaken, were absolutely new when I worked with them. I think Praveen Saab's first film, Abbas Bhai Mastan Bhai's second film, Rajiv's maybe second or third film, Kundan Saab's second, Anubhav's third, fourth film, Shimit's second filmmaking. So I think I am drawn to people who are new and making new films because I till now feel like a newcomer. I still feel that I'm not some thespian or it is actually, I'll say it again, this is very awkward to be sitting here. When I was leaving my house, I was telling my family that 25 years, yeah, sounds so old. So I took Baijin beard color and colored it a little more black. Yeah, man, 25 saal to bahut bada ho gaya hai. So I find it very awkward. I'm spending 25 years here, but I feel like a newcomer, and I'd rather be working with anybody. And if there's somebody make that has never been a deciding choice. Ki naya hai, to nayi type ki film banayega. Naya hai, iske saath kaam nahi karta. That has never been a thought in my head.
May I add to this? I think what Sharu is trying to say is that when you grow up with people, you are new and they were new. Chances are you will work with them a little more often, but it doesn't mean that you will not work with newer people who are growing up now. And I think, to my mind, that is a way of looking at life in the most positive fashion.
And also, I feel, I should say this, most of the people here again, and some of them were not present here, I was a rank newcomer. Like Rajiv so sweetly said, he didn't care how his hair was. I didn't care because I didn't know how else to keep it. I still remember Rajiv told me also, and till now he tells me, ki tum so rahe ho aram se, yani sab tumhara sab to aise nahi, main aise hi dikhta hu. I'm sorry. So I was an odd looking boy. I spoke too fast. I'm not from a film background. And most of them, even though they're not, some of them are from film background, they'd started their careers. They gave me an opportunity, you know. Himaji is not here. But to who gets an opportunity in his life to sit across the dream girl and she says, I like your nose, it's very aristocratic. So you are in my film for that. And I'm like, wo na, jisko main chupata phir raha hu, wo na Hima Malini ko pasand hai. So, you know, the opportunities I got with all of them. I remember Rajiv, Abbas Mastan, Kundan and we were working on films and television. I used to live in his house. He had allowed me to stay in the Iskra Rogopak office. The first time Gujarati food I've had from Bakul, his wife. They looked after me like their child and they gave me an opportunity. So for me, if a newcomer comes, I have been trained by people like these to respect a newcomer, love the newcomer like your own, and I'm not being patronizing or giving anyone a chance because they never made me feel like that. Not one of them made me feel ki hum tere ko chance de rahe hain beta. So I've learned from them actually.